In this video, I will give introduction to system monitoring. In SAP systems, computer center management system, that is CCMS infrastructure, is used for system monitoring. And this CCMS infrastructure is available in all the SAP systems which has SAP basis component 4.0 and above. And here we learn some of the important terms. They are MTE, that is monitoring tree element, and then monitoring object, example program buffer, and monitoring attribute, hit ratio and swap. Hit ratio and swap are attributes. Program buffer is monitoring object. And CCMS alert monitor infrastructure gives the option of central and efficient monitoring of SAP systems. This infrastructure must exist on every component that is to be monitored. If you want to monitor some system, you should have that particular infrastructure in that particular system. And SAP systems with SAP underscore basis 4.0 component and above will have CCMS alert monitor infrastructure. That means the SAP systems which have this particular component, that is SAP basis component 4.0 and above, will have the CCMS alert monitor infrastructure by default. And if you don't have the CCMS alert monitor infrastructure in the system, that means if you don't have SAP basis component, you have to use CCMS agents to get this functionality. And normally SAP Solution Manager is the best system for monitoring purpose. That means the CCMS infrastructure can be used within the Solution Manager to collect data of all the systems within the landscape. SAP recommends to use SAP Solution Manager system for monitoring different SAP systems in the landscape. And the central monitoring system collects the monitoring data for the various components and displays it in various views. Administrator will have central view of the entire system landscape using this data. And what is monitoring segment? Each SAP component collects its own monitoring data using CCMS infrastructure and stores it locally in the main memory of its host. Each and every SAP systems will have different types of components. Each component will collect its monitoring data using this infrastructure and stores the data in the main memory of that particular host computer. And that part of memory is called monitoring segment. And the size can be adjusted using alert forward slash moni underscore segm underscore size parameter. This parameter adjustment can be done using RZ10. And the system which you will use for central monitoring should have higher release than the monitoring systems, and it should be highly available system, and more resources should be available in that particular system. And the recommended system for monitoring is the system which acts as central user administration and transport domain controller. CCMS alert monitoring infrastructure consists of three parts. Those are data collection and data storage and administration. Data collection means some special programs will be there to collect and store the data in the main memory of the host. And then the main memory is not permanent, it will be changed frequently. That's why you have to store the data into the database, and it will be done at the database storage. So these three stages will be there in the CCMS alert monitoring infrastructure. And CCMS alert monitor can be opened using RZ20T code. and this T code will display the monitoring data from the monitoring segment in a tree structure. The data will be displayed in a tree structure, and the nodes in the tree is called a monitoring tree element. Each node is called monitoring tree element, and measured values are displayed at the lowest level in the leaves of the tree. These leaves are called attributes, and attributes are grouped as second lowest level using monitoring objects. First, let us open this T code using SAP system RZ20 T code, and these are all the monitoring tree elements, and these are supplied by SAP itself, standard SAP templates, monitoring templates. In this, you can use SAP CCMS monitor templates. Just open this plus, and you will find different types of monitor here. And in this, entire system is one monitor. Double click on that. So like this, node is displayed. You can use plus to expand the node and expand further using the same way. R3 services or application server. Under application server, this is the application server available, that is NWQ 00. The host name is NWQ and the SID is NWQ 00 is the system number. Expand by using plus button. Under this, several options are there: operating system, database client, R3 services, R3 basis system. You can click on the R3 basis system. Under R3 basis system, you can click on the buffers. So under the buffer, there is a program, and under program, this is a swap and hit ratio. These two are attributes, monitoring attributes. Program is monitoring object. Okay, and the attribute values are displayed here. That means hit ratio is 100%, swap is 0 per minute. And here you have a legend button to find out the symbols and color codes. Okay, this is the legend button. And here empty is monitor tree element, and red denotes there is a red alert. That means there is a severe problem in that particular node. And yellow denotes there is a yellow alert and medium type of problem. And green, there is no alert. That means no problem. And this denotes virtual node, and this denotes object, program object. Okay, monitoring object. And some of the objects are informative purpose, that is object description only available, and some of the attributes are with this symbol, that is performance attribute, that graph symbol will be there, and some attributes will have heartbeat attribute and log attribute. Like this, you can use this particular screen for knowing about the symbols. Okay, and this is about MTE, that is monitoring tree element, and the monitoring object, and monitoring attribute. And here we have red, yellow, and green colors for indicating the alerts. Let us go to next slide. Here we have pre-configured monitors. The monitors we have just now we have seen is seen are SAP pre-configured monitors. Those monitors are delivered by SAP pre-configured monitor sets that can be used immediately. Every monitor set bundles monitors that display various parts of the entire monitoring architecture by topic area. That is example database area. For suppose if you want to go to database area directly, you can use this particular section. Like go back from here, there is a database and data archiving. Directly you can open database monitor. So from here you can monitor the database. So the database client, DB connection, everything can be monitored from here. And database can be monitored from here also, that is entire system monitor, database, under database the application server and the DB connection and ABAP SQL, like this. Okay, so let us go to next slide. And alert threshold values. Alert threshold values for triggering yellow and red alerts are assigned to monitoring attributes. If the threshold value condition is fulfilled, first yellow and then red if further deterioration is happened. Color of the monitoring attribute is propagated to its higher level node in the tree. So that means, for suppose, and the color is propagated to higher level. That means you have a red alert here. That means you can think that there is a red alert under this particular node. So you can open it. Here there is no red alert. Okay, somewhere here these three are having red alerts. That means if you open application server and then the red alert is there. Like this, the red alert is propagated to its node, like from R3 services to NWQ. Okay, under R3 services there is a red alert under dialog. So under dialog, log on load quality has red alert. And if you want to know about the threshold values of this particular attribute, okay, select that and click on the properties to get the threshold values. The change from green to yellow will happen at 100, change from yellow to red at 50, reset from red to yellow at 90, and reset from yellow to green at 150. Like that, you can select another attribute and click on the properties so that it will give you the 2 milliseconds. Okay, right now it is green, that means it is below 2 milliseconds. Okay, and here you have two types of views. That is, just go to slide again, and there are two views are available, the current status view and open alerts view. Okay, current status view means displays the monitor with the newest reported data. Open alerts view means displays a monitor with alerts that have not yet been completed. That means if your attribute is showing green now and it is working fine now, it may be having alert yesterday night. Okay, if you want to know those alerts, you can use open alerts. Okay, just how to switch between the views, just check from here. Like for suppose there is a open alerts tab here, that is button, click on open alerts button, so that view will be changed to open alerts. Okay, like this, view open alerts, current status, current system status, open alerts, current status. This is current status, and open alert status is this one. For suppose if you want to open any of the alerts, like for suppose operating system alerts, double click on the operating system MTE so that everything, all the alerts under that operating system MTE will be displayed. Okay, from here you can select any of the alert for analysis purpose. That means you can find out the problem using this particular detail. Like just select it and click on start analysis method. Okay, this is the button, click on it, so that from here you can find out the reason for this particular problem and try to solve the problem and go back to the alert display and select that particular alert, click on complete alerts, so that alert will be disappeared from this list. Just see, there is no alert. Like that, you analyze all the alerts and click on the complete alerts. So that select all alerts and complete alerts, nothing is displayed now. And if you want to show those alerts again, you can click on the show alert history and all the alerts will be displayed with the status done. Like this, you can get back those alerts back. Okay, so in this way you can navigate within the CCMS infrastructure. Okay, I hope you understood some terms in this particular CCMS infrastructure class, that is introduction class, And in next video, I will show you how to create our own monitors. Thanks for watching.